Atomos just released a firmware update for the Ninja 5 that allows you to do this. And this little toggle is something I've been asking for a very long time. Let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
What's happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and you spin me right round, baby, right round. A quick note to my subscribers. On Twitter and Instagram, many of you have been telling me that you're not getting notifications about my videos amidst all the craziness going on in the world. If you'd like to be notified about all my uploads, I recommend switching the notification bell from personalized to all. Personalized is the algorithm-based option, and right now will probably favor coverage of the pandemic and not nerdy videos like mine. So switch that over if it's happening to you. You can do it right now while watching this. Thanks for your consideration. So, if you've been following me for a while, you'll probably know that as much as I love the Atomos line of products, every time I review one, I complain that they don't handle the log recordings correctly, and it comes down to the difference between full and legal range. The Ninja 5 treats everything as legal, or limited range, which has values of 16 to 235 for 8-bit. 16 is as black as it gets, and 235 as white. Then when you bring these clips into your NLE, the editing software will scale them up and expand them to fit the entire working space of 0 to 255. Which is full range, or full data levels as they're sometimes called. This works the same way in 10-bit, but the numbers are bigger. They're 0 to 1023 for full range, and 64 to 940 for limited legal range. The limited range is also sometimes referred to as video levels. Now, this doesn't present a problem most of the time, because most camera profiles are based on legal range, but log recordings are a different story and are intended for full range. This is why your image always looks more contrasty on your Atomos compared to your camera screen when set to a log profile. And it's not just the Sony problem, it happens to Panasonic V-Log, Fuji's F-Log, and so on. Now, when you record log internally on an SD card, the camera either writes the metadata to treat it like it's full range, or the NLE just knows to treat those recordings as full because of the way the editing software has been programmed. But that's not the case for the Ninja recordings, either due to insufficient metadata, or because the NLE is accustomed to treating ProRes and DNX recordings as limited, but the NLE does that same scaling that it does to all limited files, but this time it causes the log recording to clip, because it's taking something that was already fully scaled to the waveform and pushes it to the outside. Now, if you've dealt with this before, you know that there's different ways to solve this depending on the editing software you use. In Final Cut and Premiere, it's a bit trickier because you either have to reassign the values using a corrector or apply a conversion LUT that goes from full range to limited range so the NLE scaling is useful once again. In DaVinci Resolve, however, it's more elegant and you can just tell it to treat the clip as full range without the need for all that conversion. Okay, so now that we know all that, what did Atomos do? Well, what I wanted them to do was do what Resolve does. I wanted them to add an option to just treat the recording as full range and write something in the metadata that tells the editing software to do the same. But they didn't do that. What Atomos did instead was give you the option to legalize your recording, which is basically the equivalent of applying the full to limited conversion LUT that you use for Premiere or Final Cut, but done right in the recorder now to save time in post and make it easier for users that are confused by all this stuff. And this approach has other added benefits now as well. First off, you can now correctly monitor log footage as it'll be appropriately flat and won't be overly contrasty with clipped whites and crushed blacks. Second, you can use the HDMI output port to deliver this now legalized log signal directly from the Ninja, which could be great for live events or streaming. And these are benefits that would be removed if Atomos had instead gone the metadata route. However, there are cons to this approach too. Converting your footage to legal range means that LUTs and transforms like ACES will not be mapped 100% correctly because they were built on full range. To show you what I mean though, let's jump into Resolve. Alright, I've got a bunch of clips here to show you, and a lot of them are blue skies because I was testing to see if the gradients were affected by converting from full to limited in the recorder, if it would have a negative impact on stair-stepping in 8-bit. But there's also a few other things that I noticed when I was doing this. So first off, these first pair of clips here are for Legalize off. So this is recorded the way you've been recording all along with your Ninja 5. And with each pair, the first clip is going to be the internal recording, that's the H.264, and then the second one, the DNX file, will be from the Ninja 5. So if we first just look at what happens if you don't do anything to the original recording. So this is what it looks like normally, and you can see it's pushed up, it's close to clipping, and it doesn't reflect the internal recording at all. This has been the ongoing problem with the Atomos products. And in Resolve, like I said, the most elegant solution is you just right-click on it, go to Clip Attributes, and change it to Full, and then it looks pretty much the same. And you get pretty good results, and there's minimal color shifting, and if you look at the waveform here, they look pretty much the same. However, with the new Legalize On function, which is what we have for this next pair, this is the internal recording, and this is the Legalize On recording, we can see these sharp, segregated, jagged spikes in the waveform. And if we look at the overall color, it does shift the blue just a little bit. It's definitely usable, and it's overall a fine image, and for the most part, I think, you know, most people aren't going to be able to tell when you deliver this content, but I do think that it is worse than the full conversion in Resolve, and it's a sloppier workflow because you're doing extra steps. And now if we jump over here and we look at this pair over here, this was done using the Leeming LUT, by the way, so that's just, you know, applying a LUT. But I also did one over here using Aces, and it's the same idea. This is Aces applying to the internal recording, and for the Aces I was doing Sony S-Log2 Daylight into Rec 709. Now if we look at that one compared to the Legalized external recording with the Ninja, we get the same separate spiked kind of thing here, and the blue tone again has shifted a little bit. Now, because we're recording externally, our image is actually still maybe a little bit better even with the Legalize. If we switch over to the vectorscope, you can see what I mean by, if you look at the smoothness of the blue gradient here on the vectorscope, and then we look at the internal recording, we're getting a lot more jaggies, and this is probably a 420 versus 422 thing, because we are getting a better color resolution externally. There are those benefits, and I think that if we look at the banding here, you probably won't be able to get a good sense of this on YouTube. It's probably extra banded for you, but I would say I can see maybe 20-25 bands across this section, where here I would say I only really see like 8 to 10, and then the next 10 are much smoother. So we are getting better results in general just from recording externally. It's minor, and once you upload it to something that's like an 8-bit thing online, it's going to mitigate it, but it is a little bit better. Anyway, if we now instead look at these two, which were done just by manually using a curve, there's no LUT applied whatsoever, and we compare the two, you can see that the waveform looks exactly the same, and the color tone, I would say, is pretty identical too. Now we only have upside, where for me, again, I can see the banding is more pronounced on the internal and a little bit less pronounced on the external. So if you grade manually, there's no real con to the Legalize option, but if you use, you know, your favorite LUT or you use an Aces workflow, you will notice that it changes a little bit from the internal recording. So if you're trying to match internal to external, the Legalize option will make it slightly more difficult to match. You'll have to do an extra step that you wouldn't have to do if you grade by hand, or if you just didn't use Legalize and you instead used the clip attributes option and got Resolve to set the data levels to full. Now there's one important thing to keep in mind with this new toggle. Don't turn it on unless you're using a proper log profile. If you use it with a standard profile, it'll incorrectly scale your footage and you'll have an overly flat image that'll suffer even worse issues when it comes to applying LUTs and transforms. So to put it more simply, do not use this for cine-style profiles like Cine 2 on Sony or Cine Light D on Panasonic. Do not use it on HLG profiles on any camera, and definitely do not use it on full contrast profiles like standard or portrait. Only use it on proper logs like C-Log, V-Log, N-Log, S-Log, F-Log, etc. Also, if you're a Resolve user, I probably wouldn't use this option either, other than for monitoring, because it causes unnecessary conversion. There's no need to go from full to legal, back to full for editing, and then back to legal upon export, and introduce potential remapping errors and possible artifacts, when you can just tell Resolve to treat it like full all the way through the process. So for Resolve users, I think it's better to upload the full to legal LUT onto the Ninja, and just use it as a monitoring LUT, which will give you similar monitoring capabilities, but won't impact your recordings. You can use the Legalize option, but it will likely increase the chances of you forgetting that you enabled it, and then recording it that way. It's not the end of the world if you do, it just won't be as clean of a workflow. But I'll put a full to legal LUT in the description below that you can use to install onto your Ninja. By the way, does anyone know how to delete LUTs that you don't want on your Ninja anymore? I can't find a way to do this, and it's not mentioned in the manual. Perhaps that's something for Atomos to consider in future firmware updates. Anyway, all that previous advice is just for Resolve users. For everyone else, Premiere users, Final Cut users, live streamers, and event casters that are using Log, the option to now enable legalization while recording is a time-saving feature that is much appreciated. At least until Premiere gives us the range control options that Resolve has, because any issues that this conversion would introduce, you'd introduce yourself by converting it in post, but with more steps. So this has the same cons, but saves time and lets you monitor better. Also, when it comes to monitoring, monitoring, this update has brought several other much-appreciated additions to the Ninja 5. First off, and my favorite one, is now with false color, you have a legend that runs along the side that tells you the IRE values, the exposure values for the different areas in the scene. So if you see that this area here is a certain light blue color, and you don't really know what that means, well now you can use the legend and it goes, oh, it's between 58 and 77, so it's easier to do. It's much more efficient for skin tone, especially if somebody has never used false color before. It's much more convenient to have it right beside than have to use your phone to look it up. Also, they've added some new anamorphic modes. So if you go through here, the 2x was always there, but now they have a 1.8x, and I believe the other one that they added was the 1.25x, so that's great. There's also some new frame guides and grids, so if we go in here, I think one of the new ones is this 1.91:1, which is good because I think that's the width of a phone screen. I think that's what the target is for that one. And then there's also 1:1, which is obviously square video for, you know, Instagram posts and that kind of thing. And then 4x5, which is for the full size, like vertical posts for Instagram. And then they also have 9x16, vertical video. And they've also added a complete rule of thirds grid, which is great and wasn't there before. I always feel obligated to make videos like this, in a good way, because you can't just complain about something for 2 years on video and then not make a video about it when they finally do something to address it. So, good job, Atomos. Overall, this is a fantastic firmware update, and I commend you for making it. So go update your Ninja 5s now, if you haven't already. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video entertaining, or at least helpful. And if you did, make sure you leave it the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, then it's probably your range that's limited. Alright, I'm done.